Namaste, welcome to Bhavna's kitchen. Today I'm going to show you how to make halwasan. The most requested recipe in last few months because Raksha Bandhan is coming and halwasan is very popular, it tastes yummy, so let's get started. Let me walk you through the ingredients first. 4 cups of milk, which is 1 liter, 2 tablespoons of kansar, known as, you can use coarse rava or also known as suji or semolina, or you can use the fara lapsi, but I'm using kansar. 2 tablespoons of edible gum, gundar, 3/4 cups of sugar. I'm going to use 2 tablespoons of ghee. For garnishing, here I have almond pistachio, and for spices, here I have nutmeg, powdered nutmeg, jaipur, elaichi, cardamom, kesar, saffron, and lemon juice. You can use lemon or lime. There are few variations when this recipe is prepared. Some people like to use rava, coarse rava, also known as soji or semolina. You can use even fara lapsi, which are more bigger pieces. So the end result will always depend on the ingredient that you use, whether you use a rava or lapsi, or as I'm using kansar today, it's a bit of a different in between rava and fara lapsi. I'm going to heat up the pan on a medium heat. Now you want to keep the heat on a medium throughout the cooking. You can increase a little bit when you are trying to burn water later, but be sure to stay by the stove if you increase the heat. Heat up 2 tablespoons of ghee on a medium heat. When ghee is melted, add kansar, or if you are using lapsi, fara lapsi, or using rava or coarse rava basically, and cook until it changes the color slightly. Make sure not to burn. When it looks slightly pink color, and you will see that it starts foaming as well. At this time, ready to add gundar, edible gum, and cook another 30 seconds or so. I prefer to take a wide pot, so after cooking about 45 seconds or so, you will feel that gundar, edible gum, will get light and fluffy. I'm ready to add milk. I'm using fat milk. And now let it cook. I'm going to wait until it comes to boil. After about cooking 5 to 6 minutes, when it comes to boil, squeeze lemon or lime juice. Now you do not need too much of a juice, just to curdle milk. You can see that it's coming to boil faster, so be sure to stay by the stove and keep stirring. Now you can see that milk has already curdled. We are trying to separate whey from protein so that it is easier to get solid of milk quickly. You will feel that it becomes more liquidy, but that's fine. After this period, it will be easier to evaporate water quickly. While you are trying to burn water, you do not have to keep stirring, but be sure to stir occasionally, making sure that it's not sticking at the bottom. When it is about to get done, it will also splash back a lot, so be careful. All right, so it took 10 minutes to burn the liquid, so it always depends on the fat content your milk has. More the fat, better it will be, and it will be quicker to burn water. Now at this time, ready to add sugar. Now once you add sugar, again you're gonna have more liquid, so again cook until it becomes solid. It won't be more liquidy like earlier, but it will still turn into a little bit liquidy. So now again, I'm going to cook until it becomes a little thicker. I'm going to add kesar, saffron, Jaipur nutmeg. Not too much. Now the aroma is so wonderful. After cooking for about another 10 minutes, I can see that it has started leaving the sides. It does not stick on the sides. Alright, so now you can see that it doesn't stick anymore. I can see ghee oozing out and it's already nice and thick. You can see that it has become completely dry now. Once it cools down, you'll be able to form in any shape you want. Switch off the stove. After an hour or so, you can see it has got nice and hard now. So now you can shape however you like. I'm going to make ball first and then smooth out and press a little bit and make kind of a oval shape like that. And on the top, sprinkle almond, and halwasan is ready. Alright, look at halwasan. Ready to give it a bite? I hope I made it easier for you to prepare halwasan. Thank you for watching and I will see you soon with another great recipe.